This is All About the Sun.
I recently wrote a song called I Don't Like My Friends, which was very controversial. And I posted up a little clip of it because, you know, I was saying to myself, this is the kind of song that I feel like a lot of people can relate to. Not that you hate all your friends all the time, but it's, you know, it's specific to me feeling like that at one point or another. And I feel like a lot of people have felt like that. Like, you can't trust the people around you, or you're skeptical of them, or, you know, they make you feel bad. And so I wrote this song and I posted up a little clip. You wouldn't believe the amount of people that messaged me. Who's this song about? No. This is about me,
right?
Oh my God, it's hilarious. But I'm like, no. Like, everything's fine. That's what I do. Like, I'm a songwriter. If something sticks out to me and I need to write about it, I do. But it doesn't mean that I'm like, that's my headspace all the time. You know? It's interesting.
Well, it is. And I've had some conversations with some friends recently that have released songs where they feel like the person it was written about is going to get it. And I have kind of said to them, like, so what? Like, you're
sometimes they do.
Maybe they
need to hear it.
Yeah, or maybe they don't, and they just walk up to you and go, wow, what a great track. That person you're talking about, what a real, you know, like, a real jerk.
A little part of me kind of hopes, like, if I write a song about somebody specific, especially if it's someone who's like done you wrong, or, you know, there's a part of me that does it for mm-hmm. that purpose. Like, I want you to hear this because it's all the things that maybe I couldn't say to your face, or maybe I was too emotional at the time to tell you. Or that's what I love. I love that about songwriting. I love that you can just, it's you. You write whatever the hell you want. People have to deal with it. Like, sorry, this is how I express myself. You know, it's how I get past things. It's how I move forward in life. And yeah.
I wrote a song about a then girlfriend mm-hmm. as we like broke up. It wasn't a long relationship.
Yeah.
So it wasn't like huge heartache, but I put a song together and it was so poignant.
Yeah.
And really good. And like, you know, you then like, you know, finish the song, arrange it, mix it, produce it, master it. So like so much time has gone by. And I felt like I owed it to her to like send it to her because she knew that I was working on this song in a sense. And I sent it to her and I didn't get a response back. And I learned a valuable lesson that day. It's like, don't send ex-girlfriends songs you wrote about a like 3-month relationship a year and a half later.
See, I think it depends. It depends on how the relationship ended, or I don't know. Like,
I mean, just imagine like you're at work on a like a Tuesday and you get this message of this like really produced song that someone's been working
that you know
on.
It's about you.
I felt like sending a follow-up email being like, by the way, like, I'm not thinking about you.
Did I get a review or anything on the song? No.
Yeah. I was like, you can send your rebuttal. No.
Yeah. No. Seriously. Yeah. Let me know when you want to write a track about me and send it back to me.
Yeah.
Funnily enough, I've done the same thing. I've sent it to people, or, you know, and part of me sometimes, like I said, I write it because I have to. I feel like it helps me to get past certain things that have happened. And, you know, if it helps me to send it directly to them so they know it's about them.
Yeah.
Sometimes that's closure for me, you know?
Do you feel like you're able to communicate yourself effectively in regular life?
I think so. I guess it's the same as anything else, though. It's circumstantial. I think it mm-hmm. depends on what it is. I think heartbreak is such a hard thing, you know? It's hard to be open with somebody, especially if you're the one getting hurt. I think that is a very tricky thing to talk about. And everyone handles things differently. Like, you know, I think some people, they have to communicate their feelings right away. And they, you know, they need to talk about it with that person that hurt them. I think it depends what it is. Sometimes I'm like that, but sometimes, you know, saying nothing and then writing a song about it when you've had time to accept reality, mm-hmm. I think that, you know, I'm more so like that, I think.
It's good in that sense because you can get like that beginning, middle, and end.
Yeah.
And you get that bridge.
It's all about the closure, man. All about the closure.
Well, and they're also like to say on the opposite side, like there is sometimes a really great feeling to like, to write something in the moment, to express how you feel, to then it's like that letter that you write and don't send.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it's, I don't know. I've seen both sides of it. Sometimes I have a ton of songs that I've written about certain things that have happened to me in my life or certain people, and they have no idea. Like, it's, you know, they're just chilling there. Or if I have released it and they don't know about it, you know, it's out there in the world now. And you always have to wonder, like, I wonder if they know this song was inspired by them. But yeah, I don't know. I've done it always. Sometimes I keep it to myself depending on what the situation is, and sometimes I share it.
Yeah, totally.
Here you go. This was about you, and how do you feel about that?
I totally relate with you on the idea of like heartbreaking being such a well for creativity.
Yeah.
Do you, I don't want to say go-tos, but do you have like other areas that you like to write about?
Explore. Oh yeah. Like it's, I find with myself, especially when I'm alone and I have a lot of time to think about life and what's happening, especially nowadays, with what's happening. I write a lot about like just where life is going and what I think happens afterwards. And I don't know. The depths of my mind is just never – I'm constantly thinking about stuff, you know. But obviously when it's something you've experienced, you know, like relationships are always going to be the number one thing. You know, that's the number one thing that people write about, because you almost have to as a songwriter. It's all built up and you got to let it out. And that's what I love about it. But – really anything significant that's happened to me, I need to write about it, because otherwise it gets bottled up, you know?
What frustrates me about artists like Paul McCartney, for example, who write the most beautiful song. And I was recently on a trip and Martha, My Dear came on the radio. Oh, okay. Martha, my dear, da, da, da. And the song's about his French bulldog.
Oh.
Like, it's not about... You know, and you listen to some of the lyrics and you're like, this is a little weird.
But everything is like composed so wonderfully. I was interested to see how that was going to go. My dad loves Paul McCartney.
Me too, but I love that he can put the emotion that I would imagine you and I would put like something so traumatic, like heartbreak.
Yeah.
He can do that with his affection towards his dog.
It's so funny, eh?
And I think that that's like such an amazing skill.
It is.
Kind of shows like his ability to like, well, first off, he had to write so many songs and release them in such few times, like a short amount of time.
Yeah.
Sometimes I don't want to know what lyrics for the Beatles in particular are about.
What it's actually about.
Because it kind of is almost like that Jerry Seinfeld feel where it's like a comedian once said, most comedians go to the store to get groceries. Jerry Seinfeld goes there for material. And I have a bit of that artistry aspect of the Beatles, because they're just able to like
make
it amusing.
A song out of it. Yeah. It's incredible. And again, I guess if it's something hugely significant to your life, it's always easy to write about something like that. But I find it interesting, like what their headspace was at the time of, you know, them writing certain hits that they had. And I struggle sometimes if it's something that I don't really directly connect with, or I have difficulty writing sometimes. You know, people talk about the writer's block and whatever, and I do writing every day. But when it comes to writing songs, if I have to sit there and try to write something from nothing, like, and I have nothing to write about, there's nothing significant happening to me, I don't really feel strongly about this, I have a tough time. And I might be able to compose, you know, like a first verse or maybe a chorus. And expanding on that is tricky. But then I guess that's where co-writes come in, right? Get other people's perspectives.
Well, I was going to ask, I know that you've done co-writes with Tal Weisman, for example. And the songs sound fantastic.
Yeah, thanks.
Have you ever been in a situation co-writing for other artists?
I have at home, but what usually happens is like I would write like the full song or the, you know, at least 80% of a song and then bring it to the table and then, you know, someone kind of adds to it. The co-writing thing, me writing for other people it's interesting. I've done it. I find that everything that I write about, like I said, though, is so personal to me that I end up keeping the songs for myself. But I think it's important. It's important to do that, even just as a songwriter, just to get better, you know, at taking someone else's idea and, you know, putting your own little twist on it and then writing about it. But depends. Like I said, I got to be passionate about it. Otherwise, yeah, it's tough totally. For me. Yeah.
It's interesting because I've kind of refrained from doing it in the last little while.
Yeah.
But I was doing co-writes for other artists consideration.
Yeah.
And it was very freeing to put myself in the headspace of somebody I wasn't. But I went back to just me being more honest about myself, pretending to be someone else.
Yeah, isn't that funny?
I was like, you could try this song, but I think I'd do way better with it.
It's literally me, so I feel like it's better for me. Yeah, I don't know. I have a tough time with that. I'm definitely not the type of songwriter that could just be a songwriter and write for other people only. Like, I definitely need to have a hand in it because it's got to reflect me somehow.